Hi everyone, and welcome back to Big Ideas Growing Minds. We're so happy you're here. Please consider subscribing to the channel. Your support really does mean the world to us. Today's big idea comes from Malcolm Gladwell and his eye-opening book, Outliers. The book has the tagline, "A Story of Success," and is, in its essence, a reflection upon what it takes to achieve the extraordinary. Throughout the book, Gladwell introduces us to successful people. The geniuses, business tycoons, rock stars, and one-of-a-kind software programmers of the world. The so-called outliers of society. The ones that have succeeded beyond the ordinary. People labeled gifted, special, or exceptional, and are believed to have made it entirely by the grace of their own skills, hard work, and determination, no matter what advantages or disadvantages they have been given. Gladwell, however, believes that there is more at play, and throughout the book, he uncovers the unknown ingredients that helped these people become successful. In doing so, he deflates the myth of the self-made rags-to-riches protagonist and highlights the powerful influence of chance, luck, and other external factors. A key point in the book is that we generally tend to pay way too much attention to what successful people are like, and far too little attention to their heritage, meaning what is their cultural legacy, family background, and the distinct experiences of their upbringing. See, Gladwell argues that success derives primarily from a combination of opportunities, diligent work, and the circumstances in which we are born and brought up. Here's a couple of examples of things that matter more than what we give them credit for. Number 1. Date matters. A fascinating argument Gladwell makes is that the time of year you're born can have a surprisingly significant impact on your odds for getting success in life. He underpins this argument with various examples from the world of sports and education. For instance, it turns out that Canadian kids born in the first quarter of the year are much more likely to become star hockey players. He explains that this happens because of the cutoff dates to join a team. See, since the kids always play with other kids born the same year, a child born in January can be up to 12 months older than someone born in the end of December. During childhood, such an age difference can come with significant advantages in physical and mental development, leaving the kid born in January with significantly better chances of making the first team, which leads to better and more practice, and so the circle continues. And the same is true in education. Being 12 months older than a peer during elementary school can be a significant cognitive and social advantage. Number 2. Family matters. Also, the family you grow up in matters immensely when it comes to your success, or lack thereof, throughout life. Particularly, your parents' financial and social situation can play an important role. See, Gladwell makes the point that wealthy parents tend to instill a strong sense of entitlement in their children, enroll their kids in special programs, summer school, or advanced learning opportunities, and provide clear guidance and structure as their children are growing up. A bunch of small incremental advantages that together leave the kids of wealthy parents in a much stronger situation than children from less fortunate families. Number 3. Culture matters. The culture you grew up in is another important piece of the puzzle of success. Again, Gladwell underpins this statement with stories and anecdotes. One example is the impact of the Jewish tradition of working with the garment industry and other urban trades. See, because Jewish people were forbidden from owning land in Europe, many took up urban trades and professions. When immigrating to American cities, this put them at a great advantage over their Irish and Italian counterparts, who had previously been peasants and tenant farmers. Number 4. Hard work matters more than talent. Almost everyone agrees that you cannot succeed without working hard. But according to Gladwell, we still put way too much emphasis on natural talent and unique gifts. He argues that you need a certain level of natural skills to get your foot in the door of your chosen field. But once you reach the level of good enough, the only thing that genuinely separates the great from the good is how much they're willing to practice. A suggested guideline is that it takes 10,000 hours of practice to reach superiority. Number 5. Right place, right time matters. Finally, sometimes success is simply a matter of being in the right place at the right time. And there you have it, Outliers by Malcolm Gladwell in a nutshell. We hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please remember to give it a like. Take care and see you soon.